A moment like this. Some people wait a lifetime for a moment like this. Some people search forever for that one special kiss. Oh, I can't believe it's happening to me. Some people wait a lifetime for a moment like this.
Hello everyone, this is episode 6, and we're going to break down episode 6. And the first thing that happens is Renee continues to dance to the song.
She's dancing through, like, so many episodes. It's ridiculous.
Well, it's just an episode and a half.
Yeah, well, still, that's way too long.
Myrtle passes out, and the audience believes that she's dead. And what do you think of that?
I think it's kind of funny. But I don't understand how, like, when Chrissy walks in, she doesn't even think twice about an old woman that she saw in the driveway telling her that something wicked comes this way is just laying in the middle of the floor. But Chrissy doesn't even think anything of it. I mean, Chrissy's, like, one of the smarter ones, and she doesn't even know. Is your grandma, like, sleeping on the floor? Like, seriously?
Chrissy arrives at Renee's and they talk about, stuff. What do you like about that scene?
That Renee's pregnant with Brian's child.
Yeah.
Renee, like, I don't understand how Renee even got that. I think Renee was lying. I think Renee wanted it to be Brian's child. Because you can't get a paternity test unless you have the other person's DNA. Unless Renee's that crazy to just, like, go pick one of his hairs while he's sleeping or something.
She probably would.
She probably would. But I really don't think it's... I don't think it would be Brian Twist's child. Like, and then, like, I don't know, since she had, like, 20 partners in one day. And I don't even know what to believe when it comes to Renee. She's just too much.
Lexi continues, she finishes setting up the party.
Mm-hmm.
And, Natasha and Roxy show up at Michelle's house. And Natasha goes to look for Michelle, and Roxy stays behind.
Yeah. I think that, Roxy does pretty well in that scene, because she's, like, getting, like, because they're in Michelle's house, and it's supposed to be freaky because Michelle's dead. Did they know that Michelle's dead? No, they don't know because Natasha was looking for Michelle.
Natasha and Roxy didn't know that Michelle is dead, but the audience does.
Yeah, I know. So, I think it kind of makes sense being in Michelle's house, because, like, Michelle could be, like, haunting there or something, or the killer.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Okay.
Yeah.
I can't say anything, because I'm going
to... Yes, you can't reveal anything just yet. Roxy starts to freak out, and Tasha can't find Michelle, and then...
Then Roxy leaves.
Yeah, Roxy leaves.
And then Natasha calls her a stupid bitch.
Yeah, and that's the end of the episode.
Yeah.
Right? That's the last line, stupid bitch. And then the episode is over.
Your characters are so hostile all the time.
Well, they're so mean to each other, because they all like each other, except there's a couple that hate each other.
All your characters hate each other, except for Carrie and Renee.
Yeah, Carrie and Renee, they like each other, because, yeah. I don't know, it's just... All my characters, like, different things of my personality come out of them, and it works. It's fun. Well, that's it for episode 6.